Let's continue with client-side routing with React Router for our universal React app. Before proceeding, you should have React Router already set up. Now our current app only has one valid route. So our next step is to create more routes with React Router. First, let's create a directory called views, which will hold all our view components. Then rename component to view/layout. Now open layout. First, we'll give our component a display name, which will make it easier to identify in React DevTools. So how does layout fit with React Router? Layout is the main route component and all nested route components will be rendered within it. In order to achieve that, we'll be rendering this.props.children underneath the button. This special prop allows you to reference the component's children elements. Save the file and make a copy of layout called index. Now open index. This component will be rendered within layout for the index route. Let's update the display name, remove the click handler, and delete the HTML-like JSX. Here, we'll render a paragraph describing the route it should reflect. Save the file and make a copy of index called about. Now open about. Refactor the component accordingly. Save the file open routes.jsx. Here we'll initialize IndexRoute, which is a React Router component for the default route. Let's update our top level route since we changed the path of the component. Now let's add our routes within route. The first is IndexRoute, which doesn't need a path prop since it's the IndexRoute and the component is the index component. The second is a route for the path /about, which renders the about component. Save the file and switch to your browser. When you refresh the page, you get a server error. What happened? Well, the combination of using props.children and stringifying all your props to JSON caused a circular error. Now that React Router props contain React elements, you must separate your custom props from that of React Routers. Going back to routes.jsx, let's namespace our custom props when React Router is loaded on the client side. Save the file open route/index.jsx. We'll be doing the same thing on the server side as well. Save the file open layout. Let's update certain places that use this.props to this.props.custom. We'll do it for the title and the place where we stringify the data to JSON. Save the file and switch back to your browser. Refresh the page and you'll see that it now works. If you have React DevTools open, you can find layout and see your custom prop. In the Elements panel, you can also verify that the JSON is just your custom data. Now to confirm that server-side routing works, you can go to /about and with a full page reload, see that about has rendered inside layout. To confirm that client-side routing works, let's add some links. Go back to layout and initialize link, which is a React Router component that allows you to navigate around your application. Let's create a list of links underneath this.props.children. The first link will link to the index route. The second link will link to the about route. Save the file and switch to your browser. Refresh the page to see your links. Now click on a link and you'll notice that there's no page reload. Very nice. And there you go. You can now perform client and server routing with your React web application.